A 23-year-old woman presents to you with palpitations. In the past 6 months, she reported loose stools, weight loss despite her increased appetite, and she appears anxious. Her pulse is 110 per minute. The normal pulse is usually 70 to 100 per minute, and her blood pressure is 135 over 80. Note that her thyroid is diffusely and symmetrically enlarged, it is non-tender, and thyroid bruit is audible. She also has lid lag and exophthalmic eyes. So the question is, what is your diagnosis? How will you investigate this patient and how will you treat this patient? In this scenario, we know that there is some problem with her thyroid gland that is diffusely and symmetrically enlarged. So the answer to this scenario is Graves' disease and will be understood after having a brief overview on Graves' disease. Graves' disease is basically an autoimmune disease and is associated with thyrotoxicosis and hyperthyroidism. About 70% of the hyperthyroidism is caused because of the Graves' disease, and it is the most common manifestation of hyperthyroidism. The signs and symptoms are the same as that of hyperthyroidism, that is, there will be protruded eyes, exophthalmos, enlarged goiter, there will be sweating, arrhythmia and tachycardia, nausea and diarrhea, decreased menstruation in case of females, and headache, weight loss, nervousness and emotional instability. A mnemonic of it has been discussed already in the previous video of hyperthyroidism. Have a look over it. Now, there are three unique features of the Graves' disease that are specific to this disease. A doctor with her dog in the middle of Graves' disease? Yes. She is a brilliant doctor with her dog. The brilliant doctor over here indicates that the autoimmune disease is associated with HLA-BR8 and HLA-DR3. And the dog over here indicates the three unique features of the Graves' disease, that is the triad of the Graves' disease, that is dermopathy, ophthalmopathy and goiter. So this is the triad of the Graves' disease. Let's have a look over these three features. The dermopathy is also called as pre-tibial myxedema, and these are pink-purple plaques on the skin and is because of glycosaminoglycans in the dermis. Ophthalmopathy is also because of glycosaminoglycans accumulation, the fatty infiltration and the T-cell infiltration in the retroorbital space, and edema in the extraocular muscles. The goiter in case of the Graves' disease is diffuse, non-tender and with the thyroid bruit. Coming to the investigations, the most immediate investigation is thyroid functioning test, which indicate a rise in the T3 and T4 and a fall in the TSH. Then we go for the thyroid autoantibodies, and the most accurate investigation is the radioactive iodine uptake, which will be increased in case of the Graves' disease because there is a diffused enlarged thyroid gland. In case of radiological investigations, we'll go for the ultrasound scan, CT scan, X-ray and isotope scanning, which will indicate a diffuse and enlarged thyroid gland. Coming to the treatment, it is the same as that of the hyperthyroidism. We go for carbamazole and methimazole and a dose of the 40 to 60 mg per day, and in case of the propylthiouracil, 400 to 600 mg per day. The beta blockers are given because they block the peripheral conversion of T4 into T3 and also stop or control the symptoms such as tachycardia, palpitations, etc. The radioactive iodine therapy in case of the Graves' disease worsens the ophthalmopathy. So for that case, we'll have to give steroids prophylactically. For surgical treatment, we have three options: lobectomy, subtotal thyroidectomy, and total thyroidectomy. Then there are two more case scenarios given over the Graves' disease. Have a look over this and try to solve these scenarios. Thank you for watching. Allah Hafiz.